Well, a very good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to another Flight Deck Sim live stream. Today it's the 21st of February 2024, 33 minutes past 6 in the evening. And what is it today? 21st of February 2024. I said that already. I forgot what I was in. The MD11, the Rotate MD11 in xplane 12. Live time, live weather. We are in Germany, flying from Munich to Cologne. Flight time only around 55 minutes, just a little stream. I did a poll about a week and a half ago and I asked, what aircraft would you like me to fly in the next 2 weeks? And it was an override request for the Fedex A320, which you've flown a couple of times in that period. The second most requested aircraft was this one, the excellent McDonnell Douglas MD11 by Rotate. Now, I was going to fly Alpaca Airways, our virtual cargo airline, but unfortunately, there's a little bug with the aircraft or New Sky in which it penalises you for flying the MD-11. It doesn't recognise you turning the lights on. Apparently Rotate are going to fix that in a coming update. So we're actually going to fly FedEx this evening. We've never flown FedEx. They operate the MD-11 in real life. You know, obviously based in the United States, but airlines like this, large cargo airlines, will do sectors in all parts of the world, flying cargo between two airports, no doubt. Probably FedEx has done this real sector in real life. Munich has a large cargo apron, which we're located on here now, and Cologne is a massive hub, I think, for DHL. So two sort of large cargo airports operating between two here as well. Now, I am running, is it the RTX mod or something recommended by Q8 Pilot? Go check out his channel, he's got some fantastic ideas, which has sort of helped with the lighting. I actually have to say, at night now, the night lighting is very, very nice in the sim, and I have the short final scenery here from Munich, so it's all accurate and looking up to date. I had it for xplane 11, but it is compatible and has been updated for xplane 12. Anyway, who have we got here? Aaron Hastings says, hey all, hope you're doing well. Steph, happy National Sticky Bun Day, apparently. Well, I didn't know it was National Sticky Bun Day. Well, happy Sticky Bun Day to everyone else. Nick, hope you're doing well. Joe Drage, V Sky checks here as well. Darius, Daryl Edgson Smith, evening all, evening captain. Hope you're all well. Very well, thank you. Yes, Gabriel HC, stabilizer motion. Now, I've done a test sector. Can barely remember how to fly this aircraft, so you're going to enjoy watching me struggle. It seems to handle fine in most formal phases, takeoff and climb, but on approach, on landing, it's. I think there's something wrong. I don't know. I did a flat 50 landing into Leipzig, not Leipzig, Cologne earlier, I forgot where we're going, into Cologne, and I had to go full back on the yoke, and it could barely pitch up, I mean full back, and nothing barely happened, and that was with flap 50, so I'm going to try a flap 28 landing, see if it's any better, but on short final I might make some aggressive pitch inputs on the yoke just to see how the aircraft responds, because I flared, nothing happened. It handles like two B-52s strapped next to each other. It's really, really sluggish, so maybe they'll look into it in the future, or maybe it's something wrong with my setup. But I did ask in Discord and someone else said they were having a similar issue. But yeah, here we are, FedEx. Delivery looks very, very nice. I always think of the film Castaway. Was it an MD-11 he crashed on? FedEx MD-11 into the ocean. So yes, hopefully won't have any issues with that today. But yeah, it is a nice add-on. And yeah, it's just a classic proper airliner built in sort of the 70s and 80s, and with very few still flying around. I mean, FedEx and I think UPS are pretty much the only operators. There might be some other things as well. But MD-11 doing DC-10 things. Was it DC-10 in Castaway? I can't remember the film. Anyway, the reason we're doing this sector today between these two airports, there's two VATSIM events in Germany, and we love having full ATC. It gets busy. So yes, we'll have to see how we get on today. The texturing, yeah, the texture is really nice. The external model looks really, really good. And all in lovely, glorious 2K now for you as well. VSkycheck says, yeah, landing VREF is a bit higher than in the Boeing 738. Yeah, with flat 50, I think it was like 150 knots today. But yeah, we're taking 80 tons of cargo, pretty much fully loaded, just to sort of give it some weight behind the aircraft. 32,000 feet for the cruise level as well. It's going to be fun. Victor Sylvia just flew this aircraft yesterday, but in xplane 11. Very good. I think they're both being up to date for xplane 11 as well as 12, which is good. Sea average, setting the CG to 26 helped the flying brick landings for me. So sea average, yeah, who else here, like sea average, has had terrible handling on approach? For me, one as well. So yeah, maybe if I shift the CG to the rear slightly, that will help with the pitch and, you know, make it a little less stable in pitch, let's say. How fast do you post, sir? Amazing. Yes, the world on time with FedEx. But anyway, let's get the show on the road. We'll clamber up the stairs, and as I said, the cargo's already on board. I've pre-fueled. I'm going to take a gamble today. I'm going to take standard flight plan fuel because the weather here in Munich and Cologne and en route is very nice. It's just a bit of light rain potentially, but winds are good, nice and gentle. Nothing that's going to really impact us today. So I've got the little aviation light on here because it was pitch black. I did that just before the stream. So I've got this fantastic X checklist. This is a utility for xplane which is interactive, so it tells you what you need to do next when you move the switch. It automatically puts the tick in the box. It's better than sort of following along on a checklist, so I do use this quite a lot of the time. So we'll get the electric power connected, so battery on, close the guard. You can hear it, can you hear it powering up? Awesome. External power on. There we are. Get some lighting on here so I can turn off this aviation red highlight on, or not highlighter, what's it called, a headlamp. So I'll turn that off there. There we go. So we've got the battery on, the GPU is connected. Now I did say I always follow the X checklist, but I do actually like to have the normal checklist in the background here. So the FMS is sort of hybrid Airbus slash Boeing, so it sort of has a bit of both. So sometimes I just need to make reference to a checklist just to make sure I'm doing everything in the correct order. Can, glad you are enjoying the quality of the stream. Stream looks lovely. Steven says, could all alpacas please move to the back when we land? Fakes, brilliant. Aaron says, yes, the horizontal stab on the MD11 is tiny in order to make it more efficient, which makes the V approach much higher, as I understand it. Really interesting. Can always shut down engine 2 to save some fuel. It wasn't quite well like that, Felix. But yes, you tell you what, look, I'll show you how much fuel I'm taking. Look, so here's 1 hour flight time, that's with the full RNAV arrival. 17,137 is the minimum amount, look, and I've got 17,3 on board. So I've just taken standard flight plan fuel. I've increased the taxi time slightly as well, in case it's busy at the whole point. So I've allowed for a 20-minute taxi. But yes, looking good. Yeah, Rosie, another stream so soon. Yeah, but I've got some leave at the moment. So I usually, when I've liked to fly a different aircraft, like to fly two or three times in a row. So I had to sort of relearn this morning how to fly the MD-11 again. I did one test flight, so I'm really looking for input in chat. If I get a bit behind on the MD-11, if there's something important I've forgotten, please let me know. Remember, I do not fly this plane. Hardwired to fly the 737. Right, APU, we'll turn that on now then. We'll just do the engine APU and fire test, which is back here.
Engine 1, fire.
There's Betty.
Engine 2, fire.
I think I can let go now. There we are. So we've done the fire test. We'll now start the APU. So you just simply press that once, and then the available light will keep blinking until the APU is available. You can see here, look, it's starting to spool up the EGT N2 and N1. Check the oil quantity for the APU. There's light up on the APU as well. So we'll let that carry on. And then we'll put the APU power on the bus and the APU air to get some conditioned air for the 80 tons of cargo we already have in the rear hold. Yes, your bitchin' Betty is what they call it, isn't it? And there was actually, the woman did an interview about it once. I remember watching on YouTube years ago. Very good. Aaron, gotta love the sounds of the MD-11. It's lots of doop-doop, yes, and stabilizer motion and all sorts of different funky sounds going on, that's for sure. Right, I'll just wait for the APU to boot up. I've got the FTSIM sound pack because the default sounds, you know, let's be honest, leave a lot to be desired. They're not great. So the FTSIM sound pack, I'm subscribed to FTSIM, so I always grab the sound packs if they are available. Still booting up the APU. I think when that stops blinking, it's all good to go. So I want to get the APU on the bus, then I can actually disconnect the ground power. There we are. So I can actually turn off the ground power. You probably should wait a short while before you put the APU bleed on, but we'll put it on now. That's going to start providing conditioned air for the cargo hold and the cockpit. So that's done. APU power's on and APU air. I've already done the engine APU fire test. There we are. I can hear the noise changing in the flight deck. Enunciator light test. I think that's around here somewhere. Is it that one there? No, that's just the test the lights. Where's the enunciator light test, air system test? I know I'm staring right at it, aren't I? There it is. Very cool. That's done. IRS switches here. That does the cargo fire test because, you know, McDonnell Douglas. There it goes. There's the cargo fire test being completed after the IRS switch has moved to nav. So we've observed that. FMC now, I think we just put the initial position in. So FMC 1. I've got a company route downloaded, latest ARAC installed as well. So company routing is going to be Echo Delta Delta Mike to Cologne, which is Echo Delta Delta Kilo. You simply sit there and it copies all the routes in. Frankfurt's our alternate. Our flight number, is that the right, is that right for FedEx Foxtrot Delta X-ray? I sort of guessed that. I looked on flight radar. So FedEx, I mustn't say Alpaca, I mustn't say my operator. So FedEx 21 Charlie Golf, cruising at 32,000 feet. Cost index, let's go with 10. I think that's what it's on the flight plan. And initialize IRS as well. So that's all good. Walk in, the button with test written on it. Well, thank you so much for your input. Appreciate it. If you only came in a minute earlier. Right, so we've done that. And that's just the initial position at this stage. We have more tests to complete. So back onto the overhead panel, cockpit preparation. So we'll test the cockpit voice recorder. Cargo temperatures, it's actually a bit cold outside, we'll put that up to high slightly. Hydraulic pressure test, we'll execute that. So you just push that and let it do its self test. It sort of takes around 2 minutes to complete that. You'll see all these lights flicking off and on. Just press that, leave it. Emergency power will arm, that powers up the radio. Emergency exit lights arm. Emergency light test. That's completed. No smoke seatbelt signs on. So if anyone's stowing away, put them on, please. Logo light can come on. Nav lights are already on. GPWS test. That's over here.
Light slope.
There we are. Pack the parachute. Stephen, yes, we all need parachutes today.
Sink rate. Sink rate.
There we are. That's doing all its tests. Great. Anti-ice and defog lights extend. This one. I'll turn on the windshield window heat on defog. That's good. Next, set the pressure. We'll get the ATIS then, and then we can get the clearance before we start loading up the FMC. So we've got frequency for the ATIS 123.130. Perfect. 23. How do I actually fine-tune the radio frequency? Why is my ground spoilers extended? Interesting. There we are. 123. What's the frequency for this? 123.130. There we are. So I need to turn that on, turn that up. This actually controls the volume, which is really cool. I just need to turn up. So watch this. If I rotate it. Actually controls the volume.
Information uniform.
So cool. Out. Every time I fly, I love add-ons that have that level of immersion.
Lincoln information uniform. Automatic. Met report time 1820 Zulu. Expect vectors for independent parallel ILS approach runway 26 left and 26 right. Runways in use 26 left and 26 right.
Transition. Hopefully 26 left for us. So we're positioned.
180 degrees 5 knots. Cab okay. Temperature 7. 2.2 QNH 1015
Transit. Perfect. Yeah. Information uniform copy. Cut up, Keith. Thank you very much for the €6. Your motorbike being carried again, is it? Thank you.
Finally, my motorbike comes back from the Munich storage.
Brilliant.
Please be careful, Captain. It's just loosely tied down in the back. So no steep climb, please. Smiley face.
Unbelievable. Thank you very much for your €6 donation. Really appreciate it, buddy. An 80-ton motorbike, let's say, Cannock King. Yes, it's amongst all the other cargo in the hold. Thank you very much for your generosity. Really appreciate it, buddy, once again. Thank you. Now, Dante, 2K looks great, Captain. Glad I could join live today. Awesome. Yeah, the feedback last stream was fantastic. So, yeah, 2K now. All the sims set up to 2K, output the streams 2K, it's looking great here. The volume control works in the Zeebo. Yes, it does, Michelangelo. We do have the volume controlling the VATSIM volume. So information uniform, lovely evening. It's 7 degrees, cav OK, gentle breeze from the south. QNH is 1015, so we can set the QNH now, 1015. So barrows set to hectopascals, minimums in RA, heading readout. So let's just set the runway heading for Munich. 260. So we can set that now. 260, 220 knots I think is the initial speed restriction on the SID, so I'll just bug 220. Haven't got a clearance yet, so what we do at my operator, we round that up to the nearest 100 feet, but how do you actually set 100 feet? It only seems to do 500 feet. Interesting. Do you have to push something in? 500 foot increments, very interesting. We'll set 13,500 for now then. So traffic data, waypoint VORs as you want. So we'll have airports on, we'll have traffic on. I'll do gyms as well, I was feeling lazy. So traffic, airports selected. We can put more on as required. So that's set. Bank angle selectors in the auto position. Altitude display window, preset 13,500. Check the oxygen. There we are. That's all good. EIS source selector, I think that's down there. On one, aux two and check, so we'll leave that on one. Gear warning test, execute. I do not know where this switch is. I had this issue last stream when I was playing it back. I don't know where it is, but tested. Standby altimeter set as well.
Minimums.
0.5. And we'll check and set the standby. Gyro attitude indicator. Tom, thank you very much for your continued support as a member. 3 years, 3-star alpaca. Thank you so much for supporting me for that entire period of time. Hope you're keeping very well, sir. Thank you indeed. I think above 10,000 feet, it's 500 foot increment. Wow, I'd never noticed that before. What happens if the stop is 12,100? No, it's unlikely, to be fair. Very interesting. Well, didn't know that walk in 1993. Thanks for educating me there. Excellent. Pangolin said, very pleased to have got my load of only moderately radioactive llama food moved by a contractor who doesn't ask any questions. Brilliant. Right, standby altimeter set, standby gyro, takeoff warning test. That's just the same as the 737. I forgot to show you. Look at this. 1, 2, 3 thrust levers. I have it all set up for 3 engines. I removed the speed brake lever. So takeoff config. As you can see, I can move all 3 individually. Haha. So that's the takeoff config. Warning checked. Wearing blue today. Common radio panel checked and set. There's no nav frequencies. It's very Airbus. It does all the ILS stuff, I think, in the background. But next, we'll want the clearance frequency, which we'll tune up now. Yep, we've got delivery on 12173. Just monitor that frequency. There we go. Just turn that down until we can get our clearance. Transponders set, we'll do that next. I'll do the TCAS test now as well. There we are, fuel quantity. Wanted to make sure we got sufficient. We've got minimum block fuel, which is fine. 17.3. So we've got 5,750 aside, 5.7 in the middle. I think it's already burnt a bit of fuel because the APU's running, but yeah, we should always use the tank quantity indicator, not the FMC. To check it in the tank indicators up here, so we'll just add all this up, make sure we've got sufficient amount. 17.2, that's actually a little bit less. I know the APU's on, but yeah, okay. I might just slip on a few extra kilos, because the APU is a bit of a gas guzzler. So I'm just going to put 17.4, but then there we are, apply load. So I've just put an extra 100 kilos in, the rest is all set up, taxi and trip. There we are. And it's topped up instantly, so 585750, perfect. So that's done. Next is the FMC. Just before I do that, though, I want to get the clearance, and you're out in about 10 minutes' time. Can you use the center engine to adjust your taxi speed then? True. Expecting a give me 6 Sierra SID, but there's several here in Munich. The Germans love a SID.
Contour 812 will clear to Vienna, Kirby, Tree, Sierra departure, climbing via SID, flight level 70, squawk 1000. 812, respect, correct, report limited. Lufthansa 812, we're expecting around.
Oh, yeah, thanks. So someone said shift the CG back. So, really, back here? Whoa!
1123, ready for push and start.
Well, how far back do I want to go? Yeah, I had it here and it was.
1123, set up approved, hold position, apron 121780, so rubber back.
Oh, you mean all this way?
Push,
got you.
Apron 121,
Oh, yeah, it's opposite to what I'm used to.
Guess.
So, what did it say? 20.
It 121,
are we doing it based off Mac or CG? 22.5 cg. So 30%, that's going to help with the handling. Oh wow. Okay, I'll go off your recommendation then. Watch when I apply load. You can see it pitching up, look. All the way shifted to the rear. Well, that will help with its pitch authority. Okay, thanks for that. And that's just a workaround with the issues with the rotator at the moment. It will help with landing plus going with VRF. Thank you very much for that, 2 tons. And I got your message as well. Yeah, well, we, I like this idea. I need to have a chance. There's an alpaca and an Airbus. Very good. It's very busy here, actually. Just to show if I put the labels on briefly. Look, look how many aircraft are here.
To the left, not possible. You are cleared to Köln Bonn Aerodrome. Give me 1 November departure to this right.
So he's got to give me 1 November.
1000. Roger, clear Köln Bonn. Give me 1 November departure on 26 right. Initial climb, flight level 7.
Well, yeah, we've got to work now, otherwise I would have tuned on my turned on my sim and joined Munich apron. It looks very busy, so it would have been fun. Very cool. Yeah, it's super busy here. And I've taken standard fuel.
Thank you.
Clearance, hello, it's Fedex 21 Charlie Golf, stand 903, information uniform 1015, departure clearance to Cologne, please. Forgot I was going.
X21 Charlie Papa, mid delivery, good evening, information uniform current, cleared Köln Bonn Aerodrome, give me 60 departure, runway 6 left, flight plan route, climb exit, service 70, squawk 1000.
Clear to Cologne on the Give Me 6 Sierra departure, runway 26 left, climb flight level 70, squawk 1000, FedEx 21 Charlie Golf. 21
Charlie Golf, correct
entry. I didn't get word of that because someone stepped on it.
FedEx 21 Charlie Golf, correct, report your target
off. Target off time in 10 minutes, time 1905 Zulu, FedEx 21 Charlie Golf.
What is it?
Oh yeah, I don't think I updated my time. Ah, it gives me 10 minutes, perfect. So we'll keep a listen out. So, 70 is the cleared level. Squawk 1000. And it's the Give Me 6 Sierra, but it's now time to load up the FMC. Right, so, POS ref page, and we've done that already, selected our position. Next page, it's put all the information in here. Zero fuel weight's 194.9, which is 80 tons of freight. CG should be already all set, and the fuel quantity information's all in here. So, flight plan. It's very Airbusy now, so SID, 26 left, it's the Give Me 6 Sierra. Without any additional SIDs, insert. No discontinuities. All the way over to Cologne. Cologne, we can expect 14 left. I have flown to Cologne before, years ago. Is it I for ILS, I think? Transition, I'm going to go with the Gold Co. 1 Sierra. There's loads available. Oh, where is it? There we are, Gold Co. 1 Sierra. Because that sort of takes you directly to the airport. So I'll just check this for routing.
Give me 1 November
plan.
Climb level 7000.
Get rid of the yoke for a second.
1000.
Oops. There we are. So it's the RNAV arrival straight in. So we'll stick with that one, see what happens to me later. Because that's the one they use at night here in Cologne. So good. No discontinuities. The routing's all in. Excellent. So init ref now. We've done that. Weight in it, fuel in it, takeoff approach. So now it's the performance. So this is where I do need to use the checklist to decide what to configure. Now I don't know what is a, I don't know anything about flap settings and the dialer flap and what the default flap setting is in the MD11 actually. Any feedback would be appreciated. But I just followed the tutorial the tutorial. I think I've used the same flap setting as the tutorial every time. Chicks flap 15 dialer flap. Just having a look here. Clearly discontinuity. I'm just sorry, I'm just looking at the, I'll show you what I'm looking at. I'm looking at this PDF here for the checklist. I found, oh no, it uses flap 25 in the tutorial. So this is what I'm looking at here. Flap 10 should be fine. Okay, I'll use flap 10 then. Thanks for the feedback, guys. So slope, I'll put, I think it's flat in the sim, so I'll put up 0.0 slash, what's the headwind? It's 0. This is 1805, pretty much. Outside air temperature 7. Oh, oh no. How do I get the temperature? Is it 7C? 07? There we are. Flap 10 then. Check confirm speeds. 33, 59, 66. And they've gone magenta on the PFD. And what else did I want to do? Oh yeah, the NADP departure from here is 2, I think. It's NADP 2. They have a non-standard bug up in real life, but we'll accelerate at 2480. So I'm just going to put 2480 for acceleration. Ah! Why is it not liking that? I changed that on my test sector. What? Why wouldn't it let me do that? I'll do 3 fat. Let's do 2980. That's 1500 feet above the ground then. Ah! There we are, 2980. So that's good. And dial a flap 10, don't I? So I need to set. I love this. Oh, flap 10 is literally the lowest dial a flap I can go. Okay. Flap 10 it is then. Cool. Trim you have to do after engine start as well. So CG is. Oh, we can tell. Yeah. It was on my test sector, it was like 7 units. Now it's 4.5. Because the CG we put a lot further back. Oh, yeah. Flex temperature. Yeah. I'll put in like. I used loads of. Hardly any runway earlier, so I'll put 50 degrees. There we are. 99.6 with packs off. Can you say packs on? Not allowed. I think it always just bleeds off, doesn't it? So yeah, trim I have to do after engine starts, correct? And it's under the config. Can I set trim now? No, I can't set trim until after engine start, if I remember right. I've already aligned the IRS. Cool, so performance is done. V speeds are set, 220 knots as well. Taxi indicated, so I can tickle these. Flap selector wheel set for takeoff, or the brake selector to take off as well. I've set my speeds, I've set my bugs. Status check. Yes, checked. Parking brake sets. There we are. So wheel chop. Yeah, so now it's getting ready for push and start. So what we'll do here is go to ground ops. We'll disconnect the GPU, the chocks, the stairs. Weight and balance have already sorted. Turn on auxiliary hydraulic pump 1. On engine, and it's beacon lights and pushback, and it's like an Airbus. It does the bleeds and stuff for you. It's pretty cool. So what we'll do? Oh, you could type on for packs. I'll leave it, Jordan, to do its own thing. I'll get better pushback. I've updated better pushback as well, so it's the latest version. We'll connect that first.
Ground to cockpit. Toes driving up.
Excellent. So whilst that's all doing that, we'll brief the taxi and Sid. So we're going to push back, hopefully to face east. Off the cargo apron here, out via Sierra 4. Second left is Sierra, second left to Tango, all the way full length for runway 26 left. It's quite a simple taxi. I'll sit the give me 6 Sierra. So checking here the FMC. We're going to be routing direct to Delta Mike 052. Which is. Ooh. How's that coded here? Oh, hold on. This is the give me 1 Sierra based off conventional aids. There'll be another one. There's always. Charts are always funny in places like this because they'll have 2 charts.
All doors and hatches are closed.
One that's RNAV. Sid. Give me. Yeah, we've got. Look, give me. C-hook. This is Germany. Oh, thank you very much, Daryl, who's gifted 5 memberships. Thank you very much. Welcome on board, Corner Page. We've got Corner Page, Jim, Dage, Stephen, AJ, Fernine, Mike. Thank you very much, Daryl. Very generous of you. Welcome board to all the new members of the channel. Really appreciate it. Thank you. Cool. So there's, look, give me 6 Sierra departure. Then we got give me 6 Sierra RNAV. So that's the one we're interested in. Typical Germans. They have 2. Welcome aboard, guys. Thank you very much, Daryl. So there we are. This is the one we're interested in. So straight ahead, Delta Mike 052. Max 220, which is coded. right turn delta might 055, 250 knots coded, then it's direct to give me on a track northbound. I'll be at 22,000 feet by then. So happy with that, all looks good. The picture on the ND looks right. And I think we're ready to go. I missed better pushback. Is he ready? I think he is. Right, so just wanna, have I forgotten anything yet? I think we're good. I think we're good. Right, let's get ground on. Oh my god, there's so many ground frequencies. Three ground frequencies in Cologne. In Munich. Where are we? Yeah, we have flown to Cologne before on the stream. Only once before on the 737. It's only second time visited. Munich we've been in and out of a few times. Generally, I like to do streams at VATSIM events. Remember, I've only taken standard fuel. FedEx 2-1 Charlie Golf Stand 903, request push and start. Two turns beacon light only after you've got your clearance. You'd never turn your beacon off unless you clear the tanks in. It is not permitted for pilots to turn that on to get ground crew to hurry up. So they give both conventional and RNAVs for the same SID. What's the point? The FMS is capable of having conventional SIDs. Germany. A lot of German airports have both. Cheers, Darryl. Very kind of you.
Requesting push and start for the set of two. 852, set up approved. Hold position for pushback apron 12171 by
there. I have an apron controller as well.
Approved, holding position for pushback 12171 of the set of two. Do the job.
Clearance FedEx 2-1 Charlie Golf, stand 903, requesting push and start.
FedEx 2-1 Charlie Golf, set up approved, hold position for pushback apron 12170 for back.
Start approved, hold position for push apron 12170, FedEx 2-1 Charlie Golf, good evening. So that's quite common in a lot of airports as well. You'll have clearance, give you start clearance, but you cannot push until you get the push clearance from the apron controller or ground. Oops. Very quiet.
Did Tango Tango cut the ground? 12830, ciao.
12830, Delta Tango Tango, Tango, ciao.
Oh, Tor 4x4, I've just seen that ping. I get you always gift members, thank you very much. Very, very kind of you. I'm just going to mute you later because that's going to ping up. I'll say welcome to everyone in a second. That's very kind, thank you. Apron, hello, it's FedEx 2-1 Charlie Golf, stand 903, requesting push.
FedEx 2-1 Charlie Golf, hello, do you push approved facing east?
Push approved facing east. FedEx 2-1 Charlie Golf. Welcome board to Robert Goo, Derek Hook, Richard 5, Brian Parker and Steph, all being gifted members from Torin 4x4. Thank you very much, Torin 4x4 from Australia. Very generous of you yet again. Thank you, sir. Right, so beacon on. And what else do I need to do? There's the beacon flashing.
Sorry, it seems to be the yellow line, GSX, sorry.
Engine ignition switch on. Done slightly the wrong order.
5 to 5. I assume you're also not pushing
onto
the orange line
as cleared. I think, yeah, poor guys on GSX. What do you do if it's... can you select the option? Are they just being naughty? Sorry, I'm just... Where's this ignition switch? Is that on the overhead panel? I can't remember. There it is. There we are. And parking brake released. Oh yeah, the trigger doesn't work on this. Oh no! Ah! I forgot to do the pushback instructions, didn't I?
On to cockpit. Please show me where you want to go.
Facing east. There's no taxi lines here.
Control connected, full bypass pin inserted, release parking brake.
There we are.
Starting pushback, and you may start the engine.
What a beast is it? There we go. Texas look fantastic, don't they? Brilliant. Taylor, how's the LTC training coming along? I've just completed the ground school so far. They're very busy in the sim, so I don't know when I'm going to start my sim training, my own sim training for that, and the line training captain, flying captain course, because, yeah, I've got to be learning, how, I need to learn how to instruct on the plane, but yeah, it's all going along smoothly. Ground school's all passed. Right, thanks for asking. Starting engine number 3 then. So engine start switch to on, pull, orange lights, rear in action. We need an N2 of 20% before we inject fuel. But yeah, having the 2K now gives you much clearer and crisper instruments for you to watch whilst I'm streaming. Yeah, 20% fuel on. There's EGT lighting up, N1. I'm sure I'm meant to be checking all pressure on another page. There we are, lights extinguished, starting engine number 2. Oh no, engine number 1. What's the order? 312. Yeah, FT Sim sound pack's great. So 17, 18, 19, 20% fuel on.
Tiger 1045, pushback approved, facing south orange.
There we are. Good start on engine number 1.
Tiger 1045, pushback approved, facing south.
And starting engine number. I'll just wait for the parking brake to be set first. Otherwise, we'll be waiting here all day. Spirit Pod, thank you very much for the 5-pack. Yes, massive CG issues on my test sector. We've moved the weight to the rear of the aircraft.
Disconnecting tow, stand by.
Don't usually fly a tri-jet. Edge is really located quite far behind the inlet, isn't it? Yeah, CG. So on my test sector, I went to flare. I basically did this on my test sector. Oops, just get rid of the checklist. I did this or that. Nothing happened, and I went full back, and still nothing happened. And then boom, I landed. I had full back on my test sector. So we've shifted the weight to the rear. Alright, 3 good starts. Each engine's burning 500 kilos an hour sat here, so 1500 an hour. The max burns about 1800 in the cruise. Thanks for the £5 though, appreciate it, Spirit. So yeah, ran out of trim. So I've, as suggested by everyone in chat, moved it quite far rear. So yeah, that's certainly going to help the pitch. I'll have to do a little test on final, I'll just have a see what pitch authority I can have. Right, 2 good starts. Sorry, 3 good starts. I don't know why that didn't register, but that's all done. So APU air off, APU off. Windshield anti-ice as required. So on. Nose lights on for taxi. You should get the clearance first, I think, but I'll put it on to taxi now. Turn off lights. Oops, can come on too. Flap set to take off. So dial a flap 10. There we are. Spoilers arm, just like in the Airbus. Stab trim set. So takeoff approach. Flight plan. The trim was 4.5 units. Yeah, on my test sector had about 7 units. So that's 4.5 on the config display. There we go. Pitch, roll and rudder. So let's check that now. So pitch, full forward, full back, full left, right, rudders, full right and full left. It says push the nav button, which I'll do. There we are. Nav armed, and the before taxi checklist is complete. FedEx 21 Charlie Golf, request taxi.
FedEx 21 Charlie Golf, taxi entry Sierra 4 via Romeo.
Sierra 4 via Romeo, FedEx 21 Charlie Golf. Perfect, so we've got our taxi instructions. So Romeo straight ahead, Sierra 4. So yeah, that's the taxiway limits, I haven't got very far to go. So parking brake released. And a little bit of power. Yeah, last time we flew this was across the pond, nearly a year ago. We went from Madrid to JFK, flight time was about 8 hours or something. Ah, oh, the night lighting textures in this sim are fantastic. That looks great. It's not very loud out here. I wish it was Felis 747 loud. One to 1830, FedEx 21 Charlie Golf. Hi. So this is our clearance limit we're coming up to anyway.
With 5 mile kilo contact ground 1-1.
Representative 2325 taxi to MD 77 via Sierra 1-1-7-1-2-3.
So that's our clearance limit here.
Taxi to Sierra 7, with Sierra and apron 1-2-1-7-1-0. Representative 2325. Thank you.
Ground hello, FedEx 21 Charlie Golf, just leaving the cargo terminal holding Sierra 4. Oops.
812 Munich, hello, taxi to holding point runway 26 left, via Sierra Bravo
13. 812 taxi to holding point runway 26 left, via Sierra Bravo 13.
Ground hello, FedEx 21 Charlie Golf, holding Sierra 4.
FedEx 21 Charlie Golf,
München,
hello, taxi
to holding
point runway 26 left, via Sierra Bravo 14.
Taxi 26 left via Sierra Hold Bravo 14, FedEx 21 Charlie Golf. Perfect, is this...
6-5 Juliet, contact
transponder off. Oh yeah, sorry, that should be on transponder, wouldn't it? Right, so taxiing Sierra Bravo 14, so that's first left to Sierra. And then Bravo 14 is the second hold.
Delta Bravo Alpha Lima Lima, taxiing to entry Sierra 3 via Tango and Bravo 6. Alpha Gatu 409er, contact correction, contact tower 120.505, call Sanoli.
There's massive leading edge devices, aren't they?
120.
View from the stairways. It's busy here, isn't it?
Should
probably turn the lighting down slightly now at night. Very good. I keep listening to Alpaca and thinking it's me. Right, I should probably turn these off. Or turn it down at least.
Taxi to holding.
That's better. Oh, is trim air meant to be on?
Oh, yeah, November.
Oh, that's better, isn't it?
Alpha to 6 to Delta Charlie.
So, from the 852 Munich, hello, advise everyone to section departure out of Alpha 12.
So TCAS, oh, next is literally line up, so I'm just going to do my operator's checks, so config checked. Just going to do a quick config check now, make sure the horn doesn't sound. It's all good. Config checked, flaps we have 10. And the hydraulic system's all done, checked. So departure's going to be the give me 6 Sierra, climbing straight ahead to Delta Mike 052, right turn, climb to flight level 70. NADP2. Any problems, we'll climb straight ahead MSA to 4000. Reviewed. Cabin, there's no cabin. Chest complete. So this will be Munich South Tower next, I think, 120505.
Five to five with you.
Oh, I wish it was just louder, because this thing would be making a racket outside. Felis understands volume. Great. That's 28 knots, no more than 30. Now, clearance limit is Bravo 1-4, so it's going to be not these two, but coming up this three, it'll be the middle one. So much my speed, 31 knots.
Sierra and Bravo
1-3
to
Holly Point,
going 26 left
with a 5-2-5 right. Alright, so second right.
Well, what
page am I meant to be on here? Status maybe? I don't know. There we are, so second right here. Bravo 1-4's there. Traffic on short final. Engine, thank you.
German Wings 5-8, Victor Foxtrot, Mission Hello, taxi 10 speed of
1-4. Oh yeah, because it's got all the additional stuff above it as well. No, there's our whole point.
German Wings 5-8, Victor Foxtrot, Mission Hello, taxi 2 and speed of 1-4, Alpha 4 and contact Apron 1-1.
So there's the Cat 2, Cat 3, we can go to the Cat 1 whole point. LVP's in force. Two touch, yeah, I'm using the RXP script. Yeah, I had a fiddle with it, and it does seem to work well. Perfect, so that's our clearance limit.
1-0-4-5,
the first to the left confirm, Sierra, and Bravo 1-2, holding top 2-6 left, let's get 1-0-4-5.
Excellent.
God, it's so busy. Right, could I do some before takeoff check stuff here? So, I need to push takeoff profiles if I don't know.
Walker 2403, Mission Hello, taxi 24-2-6, right, via Sierra, Alpha 1-3.
That wasn't me, but 4203.
Love it. Why not? FedEx 21 Charlie Golf, Bravo 1-4 ready for departure.
5-0-5,
blocked.
FedEx 21 Charlie Golf, contact tower 1-0, this is 5-0-5,
person only. 1-0-5-0-5, call sign only, FedEx 21 Charlie Golf. Bye. Perfect.
Lining up 26 left
and 28. The Eurowings copying ahead. Fair enough, you probably checked in first. Tower hello, FedEx 21 Charlie Golf, Bravo 1-4, ready for departure.
FedEx 21 Charlie Golf, Mission Tower, good evening.
Oh yeah, it was only call sign only, whoops, that's going to upset the Germans. Oh, sorry. I was on autopilot. Right, put the weather radar on. TARA. Landing, I'll put the lights on now so I don't forget. Oh, I can see the lights popping up, look. Let's do that again, look, it is quite cool.
Look.
Beep. That's so cool when they come on. High intensity lights on there, the strobes. And, ooh, I need an EAD green box. Is that because the parking brake's set? Yes, it is. Excellent. So all I've got to do is set the auto flight, push the auto flight button, and then we can go.
Cargo 8175,
by the radar's on.
Evening, continue,
Guys, if you're enjoying the stream, don't forget to like the video. Really appreciate all the support. We're here at the whole point in Cologne, ready for departure in the MD11 Fedex Ops. Got Wizz Air next to us. All ready for departure. I'm blinding the Wizz Air with my epic strobe lights. Yeah, the cockpit lighting now looks really good with that mod, especially at night. AG Farney going to be blinding the ground crew across the airport. Window defog. Oops. Is that meant to be off or on? Off. Oh, don't know. Push the weather button, increase the brightness for it on the EFIS. The weather button.
Tower Servus München, Air Foxtrot Romeo, 26 left.
Ah! Oh, cool. I didn't know that was there. Thank you. So the master cautions for this flight recorder off when the parking brake's been set. Oh, it's busy here. So I'm using all that lovely taxi fuel. Remember, I took standard fuel. No extra fuel today. Fuel burn in this is pretty accurate on my test sector, so why not? There's TAP just landing.
Radar 127955.
Danke
zum Service. Ciao.
Oh, nice button. You're right down there in your A320. Oh, that's a defog message. Oh, I thought it was like some sort of flight data record or something. And why have strobes on now? So because I'll forget. That's the only reason. Fine, I'll turn it off. But just remind me to turn them on when I land.
Fedex 21, Charlie Golf, behind next landing traffic, left on the cargo, McDonald's, then 1-1, line up runway 26 left behind.
Behind the Lufthansa MD-11, landing runway 26 left, line up and wait behind Fedex 21, Charlie Golf.
So the cargo 8175, wind 18, 5 knots, runway 26 left, clear to land.
Holding on the foot brake. Holding on the foot brakes. And now I can turn my strobes on, but you should only do that after he's landed. I just want to make sure that is a Lufthansa Cargo MD-11. They still fly this, don't they?
I'm
illuminating with my lights. That is a Lufthansa Cargo MD-11. So, pressing the auto fly button, I've got nothing left to do apart from set the thrust. Go to line up and wait. So, MCP set, transponder. TARA strobe lights on, just waiting for takeoff clearance.
Welcome.
Welcome aboard, Martin. Thanks for subscribing. It is very cool, flight simulation. Very cool. Oh god, it's a long plane, isn't it? Alright, 26 left, clear takeoff. FedEx 21 Charlie Golf. Clear takeoff, Toga's in chat, don't need to worry about a timer, it'll do it for me. Right, I'll stand the thrust levers up about there.
So
stabilised. There's the autopilot taking over, set takeoff thrust.
1-1-8-0, danke, Lufthansa Cargo 25.
Yeah. 99.6, a little bit too much. Takeoff thrust is reducing now. Indications normal.
Behind
80 knots. Release the forward pressure. Oh crikey! Throttle hold. I think I've just got a bit too much thrust on a couple of engines. It did this on my test sector as well. V1 edges are all over the place. Rotate. A little bit late with the rotation. Oh, so much back pressure needed. So much back pressure. Full back. That's full back almost. Pause rate of climb. Gears up. And onto the flight directors. I'm always doing 200 knots. That's pretty much in trim though. Right, select prof.
Bitte, Steiner Foxtrot Romeo, wind one at 0.5 knots, runway 26 left, clear to land.
26 left, clear to land, Steiner Foxtrot Romeo.
FedEx 21 Charlie Golf, contact mit den Rädern 123, das ist Steiner 0.5, bye-bye.
123905 FedEx 21 Charlie Golf. Bye. I need to get the autopilot in. It's not that I'm not enjoying this, but I've got too much to do. Where's command? I forgot how to get this in. Is it auto flight? There we go, autopilot one. Yeah, I wasn't flying very accurately either. Right, what was that frequency? I need to get above FR to retract the flaps. There we are, to one notch. 123905 was it?
That's the 1045 traffic information. Now, landing.
Oh, I can't see the frequency.
Left report,
there's 220 knots anyway, and just need to set standards. Workload is so high when I'm flying a different plane. So, vertical speed, 2000 feet per minute. Slightly accelerates 220 knots. Slats retracted speed. So, slats up. 123905, thanks. Hello, FedEx 21 Charlie Golf on the Give Me 6 Sierra passing 5900 for flight level 70.
FedEx
21
Charlie Golf, hello, radar contact to enable climb fly heading 310 and climb to flight level 190.
Red heading 310 degrees, climb flight level 190, FedEx 21 Charlie Golf. Why are you going that way, plane? Pull! Heading! There we go, flight level 190. Profile. There we are. Got it, so flight level 190, radar heading 310. After takeoff checklist. Gosh, my workload's so high in this plane. Right, I did that. The thrusters go a bit funny after 80 knots. Something I'm not doing right. Profile I did. Flaps, slats are up. Spoilers. Disarmed. Water brakes. Off. Oh dear. Those lights can turn off. Lights can turn off. Whatever that is checked. Barrow set standard. After takeoff check is complete. So on a radar heading now, but sort of following the SID. Actually, it just wants a spacing for some other traffic. So we're going to go past the magenta line because we're on that heading now. There, yeah, flight level 100. Riding 320 degrees, FedEx 21 Charlie Golf. Profile mode. So why is it not accelerating now? Oh, is it because of a speed restriction?
Airborne,
250 knots. Why is it still commanding 250 knots? Pre-cruise checks, so fuel. Check those second lights off. APU's off. Pressurization. How do I check that? Press.
X to 1. Charlie Golf, proceed direct,
give me. Direct to, give me, FedEx, 21 Charlie Golf.
Number 112, descend to flight level 8.
Direct. Where's that direct button? Direct intercept, give me, execute. And I've got to push nav, because it's a proper plane. Yeah, the flight directors are still wild in the MD-11. You execute it, the flight director so shoots off. There we are, accelerating to 316 knots now. Whatever that is, check. Hey, look, I'm MD-11ing. Oh, there we are. Louder, please. All flight sim developers listen. External views, we want loud, and then we can turn it down if we want. There we go. The air button, that makes sense. Thank you. Pressurization. 129.1, FedEx 21, Charlie Golf. Juice. Too much work. I need a second pilot for this. How do you guys do it every day? I don't know. Right, yeah, pressurization there. Differential's 5.7 psi. Cabin altitude's 1500. Looks like it's pressurizing fine.
Top 2 is 9-0, extended tango mission. Radar 0 is 0 to 5.
direct to loop. Direct to loop.
Approaching our cleared level, so vertical speed, 2,000 feet to go. Radar, good evening, FedEx 21 Charlie Golf, climbing flight level 190 to give me.
FedEx 21 Charlie Golf, mission radar, good evening, identified. Climb to flight level 240, final level.
Flight level 240, final level, FedEx 21 Charlie Golf. No! I'm filed higher, but I'm guessing that's a cap. Is that a cap? Any German controllers here? Is that a cap for our routing? I can cruise at 2-4, it's fine. It's not a super long flight, but how do I change that in here? 240. There we are. Perfect, no problem. Right, 240 set. And monitoring the distress frequency. There we go. Looks like one compartment's at 35 degrees. Yes, I did turn it up slightly. Yeah, I'll turn it down.
Checks
great. We are back in profile mode. This aircraft's nice. When it was released, it had a lot of issues, but they've fixed a lot there. But yeah, the pitch. So does anyone chat know? Have they? You know, the CG we had to shift here on my test sector. I had the weight closer to the front, sort of in the middle here. We've obviously moved it quite far to the rear of the aircraft now, but is that making it actually pitch stable now? Well, we'll see on approach, because I could not flare on my test sector. Nothing happened. 2 dots, most of us are not streaming while single pilot flying. Yes, it does add a little element of extra work. Pat, if you're on a SID or approach with speed restrictions and you're given a direct, what speed restriction applies? Great question. Technically no speed, unless they restrict you. So if you have an altitude or speed restriction at a previous waypoint which you're not routing to, no longer apply. Usually, if you ask, do you want me to be doing the speed, a beam, or height beam, they usually will say, yes, please. But London, that's classic. You get shortcuts, and then they often want you to fly level a beam the restriction. But they do often tell you that. Sasha, thank you very much for the £2, madam. Very kind of you.
In the cruise over busy Germany off to Rimini.
Ah, very good. Rimini, very nice. Enjoy your virtual flight. Thanks for joining me yesterday in the Curtis Jenny. It was good fun, that sector. So look after yourself. Safe flight. Pangonis, are you trying to ferment my llama food, Captain? Yes. It was a little warm in the cabin. There we are, 240. I guess I can re-engage prof. Is that like cruise now? Machdecimal 7.2, 312 knots. Very good. Now, I see that's the maximum slat extension speed, isn't it? Now, what's the easiest way of seeing where top of descent is? Is it just to flick through this? Top of descent at 19.58. It's about 20 minutes. We'll start setting up any second now for our approach into Cologne. And we'll do a fuel check at Talau coming up. Where's the lighting for... Oh, it's right in front of me. Yes. I'm MD11-ing. Shep, can I ask how old you are? Yes, I'm in my 30s. That's as specific as I'll go. Yes, you don't need to ask if you can ask a question. Ask the question. Within reason. Name, I have to add around 10 knots to VREF to even be able to get a nice landing usually, yeah.
Alpha, contact Langen,
it is tricky at the moment. Whoa. Very cluttered display here of all the airports. That's set up data on. Right, 8 miles till Talau and the 1 minute to go airborne now. It's a lovely day here in the middle of Germany. You can see the ground below. It's cav okay and clear. Younger than Julia Roberts, brilliant. The prog page shows you top of descent, thank you. Where are you? Where is it? I can see the destination. 9.3, that's okay for fuel on arrival. Our alternate is Frankfurt 7.4, it's about 2 tons. Sorry, what's this mod for cockpit lighting? Oh. Hold on, I can tell you. It's the one that Q8 pilot recommended. Reality xplane, xplane 12 enhancer, and this is to address the dot cockpit lighting primarily. There's some other fixes as well. You need fly with lure and just drop that in. I was recommended to use it. I tried it earlier, it wasn't working in the mod very well, but I think the mod cockpit lighting Zima might need to fiddle with, but this has certainly improved it at night. Welcome aboard, airliner Dom. Hope you're doing
FedEx,
well.
Aaron,
he's in his early to late 30s. It's a Lewis script, yes. Thank you, Edo. I never know these terms.
Right,
do a quick check out here at Ermel. But has made this darker, I've noticed. Oh, unless that's turned off now.
FedEx 21 Charlie Golf.
Go ahead, FedEx 21 Charlie Golf.
FedEx 21 Charlie Golf, tried calling you multiple times. Contact long end 125.2.
125.2, FedEx 21 Charlie Golf. My apologies. Have a nice evening. Bye. Oops, I'm not used to FedEx. Free calls. All right, Sasha. All right. We have a number for you to call. Plock. Prolonged loss of communications. You're not distracting me personally. I've not used a FedEx call sign. I need to listen out. Radar, good evening. FedEx 21 Charlie Golf, flight level 240 to InBed.
FedEx 21 Charlie Golf, hello, Ed.
Right. Please, chat, you need to be quicker. You need to be quicker. No, I'm joking. I've got my weather radar tilt into outer space. That's not going to really take much. Put that tilt down slightly. Yeah, we just passed, what was it, Talal? No, it was Ermel. 11 minutes. We should have burned 4.7 tonnes. Where's my fuel used? 1250 aside, so that's going to be 3750. So, yeah, we saved about a tonne, which is good. And we should have 12482. We've got 13.4. So we saved about a tonne, which is nice. Nice shortcuts. Well, not really, but the taxi was a bit shorter, perhaps. Come on, FO chat. Exactly, Daniel. Someone's in trouble. Naughty step for you, Captain. I don't blame. I don't have my soundboard up and running. Otherwise, I would have done my whoops. Oh, where is it? Oh, I'll just get that fired up quickly. I can't find it.
Good evening.
My soundboard's got all mixed up. I haven't used my soundboard for a while. Mario. Oh, I found it. There we go. Sorry, ATC. Right, I better do some work before I upset any more Germans. Right, descent planning. So before top of descent, well, let's get the ATIS first. I'm going to get it in text. So Cologne is Echo Delta Delta Kilo. God, there's so many ATIS frequencies here. I can't even find Cologne. It's not even in order. There it is. Cologne ATIS. So Cologne, it's expect ILS approach runway in use 14 left, 14 right, and runway 24. Why do I go to airports with so many runways? I should think we'll use 14 left, which is the main runway. 14 right's too short, really, for the MD11. It's got light rain, so basically an xplane that'll be torrential downpours. 1509, broken at 3300, temperature 8.6, QNH is 1007, and that's information Lima in Cologne. So. Well, that hasn't really helped with the runway use, but I'm going to plan on runway 14 left. So routing-wise, I've gone for one of the 212 options from Golco to fly here. No, I've not chosen that one. I've chosen this one. This is the one it says is the night. This is the night RNAV transition. So, I think in the day they use this one, at night they use this one, maybe for noise. So, we're going to route from Golco, which is where we're routing direct to 687, 485, 481. So, it's missed all these points, it's just doing sort of the points between turns to Delta Kilo 481, then to 451, which is on the extended center line, and then all the way to Legdu. Someone's dinging me. the previous controller message says, don't worry, I don't have a number for you to call, no worries, enjoy your flight.
Really sorry. Don't fly a FedEx oven.
Seitling für der Kanik München, 136, das mal 23 ist auf der Line. Lass uns sein, ich würde 136, das mal 23 haben.
Love the banter. Oh, 30, Julia Roberts. 20, thank you for the £2. Thank you.
Yes, Flight Deck 2, Sam, you are very young indeed, but that's just how I like you.
Thank you so much, Julia Roberts, for your donation. I'm blushing. Appreciate it. Thank you very much. Right. It's because your fiancé's on holiday. We're checking the routing, weren't we? Here's Navigraph, and we're routing from there to Delta Kilo 451 to Legdo. Now, I anticipate a shortcut. So, Legdo, if I select the ILS approach for 14 left. Legdo's on the extended sense line at 10 miles. So, with the Germans, you need to always anticipate a potential shortcut. So Delta Kilo 485 direct to Legdo, take me to a 10 mile final. So I want to be at around 4,500 feet here, I'd say 5,000 feet maybe. So all I'm going to do is at Delta Kilo 485, at the moment it's at 8,400. Now this is where I think it's a bit wonky, the VNAV here, because look what VNAV's planning. 8,400, 6,000 feet. It wants to lose 2,400 feet in 5 minutes. That's a sort of a long time, you know, really shallow descent there. So I don't think it plans idle thrust CDAs. It might not do the MD-11. I don't fly this plane. But what I'm going to do is tell the FMC I would like to be at 5,000 feet at Delta Kilo 485, which is just here, look. And that will allow for a straight-in approach via Legdo. If I don't, I'll just extend downwind, very shallow descent until he turns me to the extended centerline. So that's sort of planned. Remind me, guys, MD-11, it's like the Airbus. I don't need to fill out this, do I? Do I need to fill in the ILS frequency? Or can I leave it blank? Can you remind me, please? I think, on the test sector, I filled it in, as I wasn't too sure. Liam, 51 months as a member. That's over 4 years. Thank you very much for your support for that entire time and for moderating as well. I'm afraid to say you failed your FedEx line check and they would like the airplane back. Ideally slim one piece. Unbelievable. Moderator privilege removed. Thanks a lot, buddy. Hope you're doing well. Blind Eye, how's Jack? Jack's not with me anymore. He's doing very well, though. Dennis, leave it blank. Roger, thanks guys. I will fly this again probably in the next week because I've sort of refreshed my knowledge on FedEx on MD-11, so I don't want to forget it all again. Ikri, thank you very much for your £4.28 donation. Very, very kind of you, sir. Thank you.
Hello, Captain. Hope all is well. Just finished a bike training session.
Lovely.
I was happy to observe that this time you're safely in cruise this time round. Your MD-11ing is evidently better than your Airbus.
I'm not sure.
Cheers to that. Have a good one.
Thank you, Creature 2, for the £4.28. I hope you're doing very well over in Malta. I need to talk to you, actually, I think, about visiting Malta in April. We're looking at some options for a little break. So thank you very much for your continued support as a member and your donation. Yes, MD-11 is a little easier for me than the Airbus. Donald Mosina, 46 months ago. Thank you. Any 757 streams on the radar? Wink, wink. Also time for a joke. What happens to a bad airplane joke? It never lands. No. That's, Well done. Thanks, buddy. What else do I need to do? Right, next question, MD-11. Landing flap. The only thing I need to calculate is my landing performance. What's the default landing flap? 20, 35 or 50? What is the sort of go-to? I need to set my minimums as well, sorry. I've not briefed the ILS. I'll let you answer that in chat. Oh, could you just confirm that point again, please, FedEx 21 Charlie Golf?
FedEx 21 Charlie Golf is pro seat direct D-loop.
Direct to D-loop, FedEx 21 Charlie Golf. Where is that? Bombay? Lohra? D-Lug. Direct D-Lug.
Clear 5, my kilo lower than
Nav. My German. ILS then. Sorry, yeah, flap 35 is good, just use VRF plus 10, 50 knots. I use 50, but that's just guessing. Okay, thank you. I'll that. I plan on... I've always used 50, I think. Because of the approach speeds are so high in this beast. Yeah, look, it's even with flap 35, it's 160, flap 50. It's still 150 knots. Right, with this new CG, I'm going to try flap 50 and see what happens with the pitch. Go from there. Right, frequencies courses are taken for then by the MD11, and the minimums. Is this Cat D? I guess, but it doesn't matter, they're both the same. 430 feet for the minimums. So Barrow, 430. So frequency courses minimum set. We know about the RNAV routing. We might get this other routing as well, have to confirm with ATC. RVR needed 550 metres. Terrain, no issue, really. South and north of the highest, 3,800 to the south. Climb straight ahead to 3,000 feet on the missed approach, 2.8 miles or 2,000 feet, whichever is later, probably the 2.8. Then left turn to Whipper, turn into the hold at the VOR, hopefully vectors. And then taxi performance, nice long runway on 1-4 left, presuming that I get 1-4 left. 3,800 metres. We'll go for Alpha 2. There is actually an exit here in Alpha 3. Wink, wink, certain. I maybe have vacated there in real life. But I don't think that's possible in this aircraft, too heavy. But we'll plan for Alpha 2 and then we'll request a park on the main cargo apron. And we'll go order brake medium. There we are. Checks complete. Top of descent coming up. What's this ring here? 40 miles, about 30 miles to go. Brendan, thank you. 10 months as a member. Evening, Captain. How are the new monitors? Monitors are fantastic. The LG Super Monitors, Hyper Squad, whatever they're called. I'll press the button. I always forgot what they're called now. It doesn't even tell me on the settings. Yeah, 165 Hertz, 2K, super smooth. Looks fantastic on my screen. I hope you guys are also enjoying the improved quality of the stream as well. Dennis, you never have a good look. I don't think my landings have been great in this aircraft either, to be honest. And there's no restrictions on this arrival. No, there's no height restrictions at all on the entire start. There you go. But we just got our routing direct to D-Lug, which is just before Golco. So there's our shortcut. That was a nice shortcut, actually. Look, cuts out all this here from Frankfurt. You could not go above flight level 240 because to avoid complexity due to profiles which are vertical. That's an RA. That was an RA, so I should disconnect the autopilot auto throttle and manoeuvre the airplane as instructed. Edgy said you couldn't go above 240 because of route sector. Ah, very interesting. Okay, and to be fair,
one two four seven three zero
FedEx 21 Charlie Golf. Have a nice evening, mate. I can't remember what I'm saying now. Faster is better, better than this plane. Okay. Thanks for the input there with the flight level. Yeah, Simbri planned me that high. I just went higher. Langan, good evening. FedEx 21 Charlie Golf, flight level 240 to D-Lug.
FedEx 21 Charlie Golf, Langan Radar identified, hello.
Hello.
Langan Radar, Lufthansa 974, inbound, lift me flight level 270.
25 minutes airborne, approaching top of descent.
Identified, hello, KTAT-EO 1 Alpha arrival.
There is the aircraft.
I
have to fly in the daytime next time, so we can enjoy the scenery, get some more fun going. But yeah, I'll probably fly this again, certainly next week. Well, I've tracked that RAO. Another airplane, there's an aircraft quite close behind, but oh, he's 20 miles. Alright, approaching top of descent then. Requesting descent when I can. There's so many frequencies online, it's crazy. Hi Marcelo, good evening. Do you know VATS Airplane Tools Performance Calculator? I've heard of it, but I've never used it. FedEx 21 Charlie Golf, request descent.
FedEx 21 Charlie Golf, descent to flight level 180.
Set flight level 180, FedEx 21 Charlie Golf. So profile. Oh, I'll just wait until the arrow. And will it Boeing and go down automatically, or will it Airbus and I have to do something to get it to descend? Oh no, there it goes. Top of descent. So, this is the descent speed, I think. 295, yes. See how it does. There we go. Don't really hear the engines. This, here. What does that say? Add drag. We'll monitor that. I'm still not used to this FedEx call sign, guys. Struggling with it. So this is sort of a, what's the rate of descent right now? Just 2,000 feet per minute, and I think it probably would reduce speed. I don't know. Thrusters are idle, but I just don't know this airplane at all. Or and I, my basis of how things work is based off the 737. So when aircraft do things differently, sometimes I can perceive that as it should be doing that, but it actually is doing it correctly. In icing? No, above all the cloud here. Remember, there's been a light rain in Cologne this evening. The wipers are here, and they do wipe the rain. Brendan, any idea when the next failure stream will be? It takes about a year to recover, so when it's been over a year since the last one, which probably is, I might do another one. Hard they are. Don Amosina, have you seen the inside of the Air Serbia video? I haven't. Can you share that with me, please? If you guys aren't aware, there was an E195 out of, was it Belgrade? Actually, we streamed out of there not long ago. They took the wrong intersection, and it was very, well, how? Oh, the angels were looking after them, I don't know, but it was so close to being, well, everyone dying. Basically, they took the wrong intersection, crew error, took off, and they were on the ground over the end of the runway. But yeah, it's as a pilot, you've got to dot the I's, cross the T's, and it's just usually could be one error. Usually all the holes will line up and there'll be things that happen in those crew in their head beforehand, which may do it. So yeah, you know, the threats are there. It's night. You can think it's the correct airport. You know, check out Bellerico's video on it, it's really, really good. But yeah, that was so close to being the next series. Thank you very much, Torin4x4. Not only are you gifted members, you've sent in a donation. Thank you, sir.
Captain, is there any EDDM you use for frequencies, course minimums, etc.?
Very good question, Torin4x4. So, some people use acronyms. My airline has several acronyms, which I'm not going to repeat, everyone knows what they are anyway. And so flight level 110, FedEx 21 Charlie Golf. So 110. So yeah, things like what do I need to have set up? We have an acronym at work, but for me, I use, it's not really an acronym. It's just frequencies, courses, minimums, fixed rings, and those are sort of the everything you need to set on the chart is then set in the aircraft, then obviously you need to brief it. But there's not really any others. I have another one, which is after we do the landing clearance at my operator, I check three things. One, landing checklist is complete. Two, I've sat the cabin crew down. And three, we have our landing clearance. So whenever I have, you know, got the landing checks complete, I always check those three things before we touch down as well. Now I'll tell you a little story if I've got time. I was flying into Alicante once and there was an issue with the tower frequency and the approach frequency handed us over to tower. We checked in with tower, the correct frequency, and we didn't get any response. Checked in three times, no response. Went back to the approach controller, and the approach controller had closed the frequency or went to a different frequency. We got no response there. So we checked in with approach, back in with approach, no ATC. No ATC with tower. We're at 1,000 feet, and I was about to click go around. But I just turned on 1:1.5, which was on VHF2, and it was the tower. It was Alicante Tower was giving us our landing clearance. And they had their radio had failed, or they had an issue with the radio. So I have another SOP. A lot of people I fly with at my operator, it's not SOP, when they get to 10,000 feet, they detune 1:1.5, not to monitor it. I always monitor it and have it on very low, just in case someone tries to call you. So that's something I do, it's my little thing. Click profile. I'm in profile, aren't I? Oh, is that for top of descent? I think we're all good, Jeff. Yes, cadet, that works well. I've not had GPS spoofing, but we have had changes to our procedures, William, to allow for or to accommodate GPS spoofing. Mostly associated with, you get terrain warnings in the cruise, you can disregard certain situations. Right, seatbelt, no smoking's on. Am I in clouds? Can't really see the strobe flashing on the visibility. No, we're just above it though. Anyway, I need to start concentrating. And radar FedEx 21 Charlie Golf, after Gold Code, can we expect the Gold Code 2 Sierra?
FedEx 21 Charlie Golf, stand by, descend at 1,500 feet per minute or greater.
1,500 feet per minute or greater, FedEx 21 Charlie Golf.
Go VS. 21 Charlie Golf, contact Langen, 135.350.
135.350, FedEx 21 Charlie Golf, bye bye.
Alpaca 652, let's descend to flight level 1.
Radar, good evening, FedEx 21 Charlie Golf, descending flight level 110, Gold Co, 1,500 feet per minute or greater.
FedEx 21 Charlie Golf, Langen, hello, information Lima, expect ILS 1 for left, continue present heading.
Information Lima is copied, and vectors now for ILS 1 for present heading, FedEx 21 Charlie Golf. So present heading, oh, I need to, go heading, is that Paul? I think that's in heading select.
562 Langen,
how do I identify?
Come
no, it's not. How do I get it to do the heading? Pull again. Push. How do I heading? Ah, well, I pulled it last time. 319. I was just playing with the heading just to make sure it was turning. Come, don't turn back. He's going to tell me off. Turn back. No, why is it not turning? Paul! Oh, I've got to pull it again! Oh, God, he's going to get cross. So you have to pull it every time you change the heading? Stupid plane. Who designed that? Why don't you just rotate it?
Did
a nice little S turn. Oh, what I really like is, if you want to know what your clean speed is, it's on the... you find it here. So the clean speed is 212 knots. So I'm gonna start slowing down to 250 now. Now, if I want to slow down, because yeah, this is broken. Because I did this on the test sector, it didn't reduce to 250 or 100. It just blasted through and just went more drag. And I was like, okay. So I'm gonna bug 250 now. 220 knots. Our FedEx 21 Charlie Golf. So I'm gonna bug 220. I'm gonna use speed brake now as well. Oh no, I went for the speed brake lever, I don't have one. It's a thrust lever.
Yeah.
Auto brake off?
What?
Struggling to slow down. No, I want to. Paul. Ah, this is the differences there. Come on, slow down. I've got the speed breakout, idle thrust. Why is it not slowing down quicker?
742 descent to flight level 70.
It's really slow to slow down.
2033 descent to flight level
70. Speed breaks out, isn't it?
Level
80, I can't see. Oh, am I in cloud? I better put a bit of engine anti ice on. You never know what can happen in xplane with icing. Now, reducing to 220. Do I need to pull it again? Oh, yeah, you have to keep pulling it if you want to do the new thing. Right, so level at 110. Speed's approaching 220 knots. Right, it's thrust coming up, so. Stow the speed brake. See all this landing forms we did? That's done. Minimum set. I've set my flap wheel. I'll put that to something random, maybe flap 15. I can use it as an intermediate flap setting. There we are. Holding at 10,000 foot checks. Please do 220 knots. Thrust, come on. Stabilizer motion. Yeah, thrust coming up. God, it's busy, isn't it? Flipping heck. The pull of a knob is just good for you not to get too bogue feeling. So yeah, every time you change your speed of heading, you have to update it. You have to push something, do you?
Okay. Speed 220 knots,
speed 2033. There's Nigel. 2120, Ryan, 360 degrees, FedEx 21, Charlie off. So delay vectors, pull. Just to get it going in its way, and then I'll pull it again, look. Pull. So delayed vectors now. Actually eating up into my extra fuel. Which I didn't take.
2033,
also, I noticed on the logo light, I don't know, is that correct? It's not really illuminating FedEx, it's like why is my clean speed look, it's like my attitude's at like 10 degrees, and what's this? Is this like stick shaker activation? I feel like I should have some flaps out. Yeah, the night lighting in xplane's good. Oh no, you're out of the box. I think on one of these you can actually see all the planes.
742 contact director, 121055.
Busy.
1055 740
by director.
21 Charlie Golf, turn left heading 330.
Left heading 330, FedEx 21 Charlie Golf. You said FedEx so quickly I could barely hear it.
Right, well, good evening, Alpaca 65 Juliet.
Left heading, did he say?
65 Juliet, hello, continue present heading, expect that.
Why are we going, plane?
Heading 330.
Why is it going that way? I'm pulling it! I pulled it! Why is it going right? I don't understand. Look, why is it turning right? Nice. It did say left heading 3. Well, I turned it that way. Stupid add-on.
Left 330, speed 2033.
What for FedEx 21 Charlie Golf? FedEx 21 Charlie Golf, left heading 330.
Yeah, I told it to do it. Turning left now, 330, FedEx 21 Charlie Golf.
Station calling in, say again.
Why did it turn that way for? I swear it's done that before in the past. Right, I'll get the autopilot back in a second. I mean, it could well be something silly I did, but I don't know. The flight director bar is very sensitive. Right. Oh! The flight director bar is like all over. Okay. Okay. Autopilot in.
Left heading 270,
Right, heading 330. But why did it turn right?
21 Charlie Golf, turn left heading 250.
Left heading 250 degrees, Fedex 21 Charlie Golf.
2033, contact director, 121.
Right, pull. Turning left.
Director 121.055,
2033,
next time.
Yeah, the Germans are not happy. I'm going to have to play that back though, because I don't know why it turned right. Yes, I feel like I should have some slats out or something. I don't. Oh, why? Come on, auto throttle. Oh, it's like right on the maneuver margins.
21 Charlie Golf, descent flight level 90.
Descent flight level 90, FedEx 21 Charlie Golf. 90. I'm above the up speed, so I shouldn't need flap. Vertical speed, 1,000 feet per minute. Yeah, look, the clean speed is 211 knots, so I'm doing 10 knots above minimum clean speed. It's a known bug reported 2 years ago. I think I've had this on a stream before, Lima Echo Lima. I put a heading and it turned the wrong way. I mean, that's quite a bug. I took control, took the heading into account, and we're now heading in the right direction. The wallet for me, Mr. Scott. Right, I feel like I should update something here. How's my fuel? Okay, 7.4 for the alternate, we're okay. Right, post-cruise checks now. Lights, logo, pressurization set. Check the plates. Right, I'm just going to update the FMC. I'm going to route direct to Duds Kilo 687. But leave it in heading. Just tidies up the FMC. This control is good, but he's very quick. He's speaking too quickly, so it's really hard to hear call sign. Like, 14 November. Sometimes he's missing out FedEx, so he's sometimes just saying 21 Charlie Golf. Heading 210 degrees, FedEx 21 Charlie Golf. So yeah, controllers are meant to say you're operating, because the reason is you're listening out for that cue, so I'm listening out for FedEx or Alpaca or my operator. If you just go 21 Charlie Golf, you're going to miss the call, especially if you're in a high workload situation, which is me flying an MD-11. FedEx operated by Lama Air. Right, getting vector downwind now though. There's 90. Yes, Brendan, well noted. It's RT is really important, and I have some bugbears. One of them is when my colleagues, and I will emphasize this as LTC, I won't say it the first time, but it's when people change the frequency, they press this button and start talking immediately, and they block. They block people. That's my big one. Second one is when controllers and the French are the... No disrespect to the French, but the French controllers are quite guilty of... For example, my operator, if I had this call sign 21 Charlie Golf, they would sometimes just go Charlie Golf, contact 132560, and it's really busy, and it's like, how earth are you going to meant to pick up Charlie Golf? So no, it's blah blah blah, 21 Charlie Golf. He's doing it on everyone though, but you know, if you're listening out, it's fine. But you're gonna catch it. I think it's like 4 Tango November's got a ring to it, too much Charlie Golf, it's not ideal. Right, so I'm being slotted in behind this aircraft here, but he's quite close. It's only about 3 miles, but 2,000 feet below. Why is that tolerated anyway? Well, it shouldn't be. It doesn't happen very often. 21 Charlie Golf.
14 November, confirm 121055.
Rosie, it's certainly a bit of an accessibility issue, especially on VATSIM, speaking very quickly with the radio. Yeah, so yeah, it sometimes has the negative effect.
21 Charlie Golf, turn right, heading 290.
Radar heading 290 degrees, FedEx 21 Charlie Golf. Right turn, there we go. Yeah, because sometimes it has the problem. If they speak quickly, they miss it. Then he has to call two, maybe three times. And in that time, if he'd said it slowly with the call sign, the guy would have heard it. So it's a negative, has a negative effect. In fact, it slows things down. Right, this is vectors downwind now. Descent flight level 70, FedEx 21 Charlie Golf. 70 and vertical speed, just do 2,000. Well, 1,000's fine, because I'm downwind. Another thing that it seems like, you know, when you're giving a heading, you should say degrees. You know, heading 290 degrees, because what else could 290 be confused with if you don't say degrees? And it happens every year. It'd be misconstrued. So you need to distinguish between flight level, altitude, heading, degrees. Alright, I'm just coming out the cloud now. Lights coming in. You can see it's a bit of precipitation on the windscreen. Speed. Not speed. If someone said flight... no. Just saying, you know, heading 290, if they miss out degrees. It could be misconstrued of, for example... Right, heading 300 degrees, FedEx 21 Charlie Golf. Confused with an altitude. So if you miss the heading and you just go 300 or not degrees, it could be misplaced with altitude. You've got it, Pedruco, yeah. So especially if you get heading and altitude, for example, fly heading 290, climb flight level 300. If you say degrees, really emphasises it's a heading and not an altitude. There's Cologne there, just coming out the clouds. Cologne down below. So already at the clean speed. You can't put fixed rings in the MD11, can you? There is a fixed page, but I wouldn't know what to do. Put 1-4 left, maybe? So say the frequency again, FedEx 21 Charlie Golf. 21055, FedEx 21 Charlie Golf. Bye bye. That's point proven. Obviously, I was trying to just listen. Not in database. Cologne Director, FedEx 21 Charlie Golf.
FedEx 1 Charlie Golf, hello. It's 200.
200 knots, FedEx 21 Charlie Golf. So I will need now slats. So slats, 200 knots, and pull. What if throttle reduces?
November descent altitude 5,000 feet, QNH 1006.
That frequency is 121055, Steve.
Charlie Golf, turn left heading 280.
Left heading 280 degrees, FedEx 21 Charlie Golf.
Moving 796, turn left heading 180, cleared ILS.
I'm back in the precipitation, but we've got the engine anti-ISR. Left heading 180, presume we don't need any wing or tail icing. What is the temperature actually? 5 degrees.
Rotate tower
124, decimal 980,
speed
2033, next plane. Cologne tower then, it'll be next. So busy. So, vector downwind, wait for further descent.
Plotting on November, turn left, 230, descent 3,000 feet.
Try putting EDDK 1-4 left. I don't know if it works.
One Charlie Golf, descent 5,000
FPS.
Feet, NH1006.
That's what you do in the Airbus, isn't it? I think that might mean for me, but again, it was too quick, I couldn't understand.
One Charlie Golf, descent 5,000 feet,
two Charlie Golf or something. But yeah, there you go. You know, his radio is not very good, to be fair, either. So leg do's on around a 10-mile final. We're a bit high now, so I'd like to get descent if we're getting a straight in after this guy.
Tango November, radio speed 200.
Using 200,
Tango November. FedEx 2 Charlie Golf, descend 3,000 feet, QNH 1006.
Descend 3,000 feet, QNH 1006, FedEx 21 Charlie Golf. 3,000 feet, and then it's a pull for this one for level change, isn't it? There we are. Two times missed. I'm genuinely trying to hear, but he's speaking way too fast for me. And his radio's clipping. If you play it back, I'm literally just listening for ATC.
652, let's hello, radio speed 100.
Speed 200, all packets 650.
3,000 feet. What was the Q&H? 1008. There we are. Passing 6,300, 3,000 feet, no flex. Standby on 2%. His radio's clipping, like it's, hear this sort of clipping sound. 1006, sorry.
Correction, heading
1007. 1 Charlie Golf, turn left, heading 2444 base.
Left heading 240 degrees, FedEx 21 Charlie Golf. The radio's clipping a lot, I can barely hear you.
Oh, that's unfortunate. I tried to fix this.
Good. Can you hear that, guys? 240, but that's looking good, actually. Base leg.
Following on November, speed 170 knots.
I'll take another flap setting. This is looking good, actually. Base leg, 5,000 feet, coming up to leg 2. Level change has worked out well. Oh, look at the night lighting, guys. Gonna go vertical speed now.
Packer 652, let's turn right, heading 050.
There we are, vertical speed 1,000 will do, 200 knots. Pilot excuse 4273, brilliant. There's Cologne. I'm nice and low now. Oh, my FPS has gone up though. Oh, 26 FPS, guys. Sorry about this. What on earth's causing that? Is it all the traffic in Cologne, I wonder? Yeah, if I zoom in that way, that's killing my FPS. Want to go. Let's just do. Ooh, don't want to climb.
Starting on November, maintain 170 knots until 5 miles.
Maintain 170
knots. Perfect.
5 miles.
Yeah, the call sign is now 1 Golf Charlie. Yeah, that's why I'm missing my call sign. Everything can't explain to you.
Starting on November, I can't say we are.
Right, hopefully a nice little turn on to base leg soon.
November, Roger, contact tower 1249980.
I'm actually going to preset the heading because we're going to go through the localizer here.
21 Charlie Golf, turn left 170, cleared ILS 14.
Left heading 170 degrees on that heading, cleared ILS 14 left, FedEx 21 Charlie Golf. Right, heading select 170 and approach armed VS 300 feet per minute. That's looking good. I've got my dialer flap in, flap 15. Bit of cloud again, so engine anti-ice coming on. This, the auto throttle's not very good at holding speed, is it? 200 knots, but it's. Oh, it's 199. my apologies, Rotate. Yeah, my FPS is.
Golf, maintain 180
or not so great until 6 miles. 160 till 6, FedEx
21 Charlie Golf. 180 knots till 6,
FedEx 21 Charlie Golf. I can barely hear him. Like, it's really. The radio's
cracked.
There we are, established now. 180 knots till 6 miles. We're at 9.6. So, as soon as we pass that, I think I can push the FMS speed button and it'll do it all for me. Right, arming this. Oh no! Arm the speed brake. There we are. Oh, it's raining. Oh, my FPS is going down. Land arms, about to get glide slope capture. Oh no, it's already out. Captured. Missed approach attitude is set. So I'm going to push FMS speed now, so that's now going to do 164 knots. And the missed approach attitude is 3,000 feet set. Oh, I haven't seen that for a long time. My FPS, guys.
And now I'm getting
warnings. Right, gear down. Flaps 28. Oh, my FPS, guys. Whew. Sorry about this. 0321 short. Strange that you have so much trouble hearing him. Guys, is it just 0321 short? Because it's really clipping for me. And you should be hearing exactly what I'm hearing. Should be hearing exactly what I'm hearing there, but it's, I'm flipping off there. Oh, lovely day.
X-Alpha Romeo, Alarv und Radio Speed 200, turn left heading 280.
Speed 200, left.
To be fair, AJ, it is raining here. There we are. Still with approach. FedEx 21 Charlie Golf, we are fully established.
Charlie Golf, connect tower 14980.
I'd say that frequency again, FedEx 21 Charlie Golf. I can't hear him.
Charlie Golf, frequency 124980.
124980, FedEx 21 Charlie Golf, bye. I definitely didn't hear that first time.
Bye-bye.
Thanks. Honestly, it's like... There we are. Adding flat.
Thank you.
Hello, FedEx. Yeah, explain this. Yeah, I have performance issues like this sometimes. FedEx 21 Charlie Golf, establish ILS 14 left at 4 miles.
21 Charlie Golf, Cologne. Hello, wind check 160101, departures rolling.
Roger, FedEx 21 Charlie Golf. Perfect.
7 Alpha X-ray
so what is the FPS I'm getting right now? I'm getting 20 FPS in the sim. Wow.
Bye-bye.
Roger,
continue
could be that. I'm streaming at 2K. Checked. Right, I'm going to get my thrust levers lined up. There we go. What's ground? 1-1-7-3.
21 Charlie Golf, runway
14
left, cleared to land.
14 left, cleared to land, FedEx 21 Charlie Golf, surface wind.
60100.
Cool. Right, cleared to land, autothrottle disconnected, autopilot disconnected. So I'm just going to quickly... check the pitch. No, it still handles like the Titanic in custard. It's so it's really sluggish. So I'm going to try and flare at 50 feet, but you might see I flare and nothing happens. Continue. Three whites is fine in this beast. Four whites not so nothing's happening. It's like unflyable. I can't. I flared so much. It's exactly what happened on my test sector. Like, I pitched like that, nothing happens. Manual braking. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Cologne. I'm gonna get off here high speed. Alpha 3, holding short the echo. FedEx 2 on Charlie Golf, no problem. Hey, helping out ATC. Yeah, you saw it, guys. I mean, I literally went like that, and nothing happened. Like, it's got no stability in pitch. Anyway, I think it's the only controller I've pleased this evening. Everyone else, the Germans will be gone. He's very happy because I managed to vacate Alpha 3. So he wants me to hold short of Echo, so I'm just going to wait here. Oh dear. Yeah, I can't do anything about that. That flare. I got wasted on my test sector. 1-1-7-3-0, FedEx 2-1 Charlie Golf. Bye. Yeah, we'll watch the replay and... at least it's a known issue, it's not just me. Ground, hello, it's FedEx 21 Charlie Golf, vacated 14 left at Alpha 3.
FedEx 21 Charlie Golf, current ground, taxi, stand Echo 16 via Alpha.
Echo 16 via Alpha, FedEx 21 Charlie Golf. Right, Echo 16 via Alpha. That is... found it, perfect. So we're going to taxi straight ahead. Second right Alpha, and the stand will be on the left. There we go. Yes, interesting. So my workload is obviously very high here. But I had issues understanding the controller state. How many streams have I done? 400? That's the first time I've had issues. I'm pretty sure the ATC shortcuts. I'm unfamiliar with FedEx call sign as well. That didn't help. But that was a nice job. We're here. And we're in one piece-ish. Heavy landing inspection required. But you saw what happened. I flared. And went from there. Cologne is heavy on FPS for some reason if you have max settings. They're quite high, but is the default, is it one of the, is it default, is it? Or because some airports have all like trees and stuff like new default. New York is an FPS killer as well. Right, let's get the APU started. That's the APU bleed. APU power, there we go. Good, Echo 16 will be on the left up here. What else can I do on the cleanup? Yeah, that is unflareable, this aeroplane right now. Switch off the weather radar, please. Yes, sir. let's put that into transponder. Standby on stand. Strobes. Yeah, seems to be a bit better.
Hello, Alpha 6528 Alpha 3, short of Echo.
There we go.
6-5 Juliet, continue taxi via Echo, hold short, Alpha.
Busy here in Cologne. Cheers, Liam, glad you're joining the stream. Just please the controllers improve your score on New Sky. And my Delta, that plane won't flare. Yeah, it should flare a bit. I mean, on my test sector, I moved the CG, but on my test sector, at 50 feet, I went like that, full back, and nothing happened. Nothing. If I had to go around, I don't know what would have happened. On that one, it was better, but I still went, I was like that. At 30 feet, I was like, nope, and I went like here, and I was like, yeah, that ain't flaring. It's unflareable. I need to fix that. Never used to be that bad. I remember when it released, it was fine. But I remember the last stream I preempted it, sort of flared at 50 feet. Weather is still on. Oh, sorry. I'm trying hard here. okay, 1-4. There we go. Happy guys! I'm trying! Alright, there we go. What's that? I think the approach controller left a bit of a sarcastic comment at the end. What did he say? Is the radio better for you now? I think I'm on the wrong stand. I don't care anymore. I think I'm on Echo 14 number 2. Oh, my flaps are still out as well. Great. Now we'll go with that one. There we go. Ah. Look at the rain. Flight deck to despair. Oh, nightmare. Where's my NG? Parking brake set. Is my APU available? It is. I'll just turn that down now. Right, I can turn my wipers off. The wipers work very well. Have I meant to have had that off as well? I don't know. Right. 1, 2, 3. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Cologne. 80 tons of cargo. And I'm tired after that. And it was only, what was it, the flight time? 58 minutes? Good job, I don't do 2 sectors in this beast. I like it, I just hope they fix the flare thing. And I think a lot of it is my inability to fly the aeroplane. I don't know it very well. But we're here, look, and we're alive. Plenty of fuel left, we need 7.4 to divert. So we're like, what did we have in the end, actually? 2750 assigned, 2850. That is going to be 5.5 in the mid, and then 2850. So 83. We had an extra ton left, which in this is about... only about 5 minutes until we're down to our reserve fuel, but that only took standard fuel, remember. What else should I have done here? This checklist. I should have ran this before landing, but we did most of that, to be fair. Flaps, throttles, idle, flare, reverse thrust I did, auto brake. Right, let's do a bit more of the cleanup. So auto brake off, flaps, slats are up, stab trim 3 degrees on the taxi in apparently, which I can't now set because the engines are off. Weather radar off, TCAS to standby 2000. First time I've had FPS drop off like that. Windshield, landing lights are off, nose light, taxi as required. We're going to have it off now as we're on stand. APU have started. APU, we can put the APU air on. parking procedures are all done. Seatbelt signs off. Nav lights as required. IRS. We'll leave it there. We'll leave it in the transit for the next crew before we do the replay. Perfect. Thanks, Aaron. Glad you enjoyed it. Bouncing on the runway. Boeing, Boeing. It didn't actually bounce much, did it? How many... annoyed this Dominus Cena. I've annoyed a lot of Germans this evening. I was looking for the 999 meme, but I couldn't find it. Yes, I'm sorry to any of the controllers. I did my absolute hardest, and the plane started going off on that heading as well. He was not pleased, but I did miss several RT calls. I think it was a combination of not being used to FedEx, shortened call signs, but hey, that's why there's two of us. Anti-ice is still on. Yes, I was just testing you. Well done for spotting that's the anti-ice was on. You win, Jim Dage. Nick, the MD-11 is known to be a handful in the flare when landing heavy. Many over-stress landing incidents reported. Another one added to the list then. There we go. Right, we'll call that a day. Love the add-on. It is available on the xplane store. Let's hope that they... people who I know fly this said it's hard to flare, and I think something's not right. I've done two flights of it. It just... Well, I can't pitch up in a landing configuration. It's impossible to pitch up. Right, we'll do that. Log off of VATSIM. Thanks to all the controllers for the ATC. Very busy event. I enjoyed taking the MD-11 out for a spin. We will take it out again very soon. Right, I've done that. Let's have a look at this replay then. If it doesn't crash, that is. There we go. Right. I hope the replay does crash. Damn it. It's working fine. I don't think you'll see it very well though, because it's night, which is also a good thing. Right, let's see how bad it was then. Cheers, Edo. I did flare a bit. You know what? It doesn't actually look as bad as it did from the inside. Yeah, I flared and it just didn't do much. Was my speed a bit low, maybe? Now, if my speed was low, that's sort of how the aircraft would behave. I'm just going to hold the camera position so it doesn't move, so I can actually see. Let's have a look from here. You know what? Very firm. Well, you know, I would say hard landing inspection required, but it didn't look as bad. It didn't bounce at all. But certainly I haven't had many wasted. Bit of a crosswind there. Looks like I flared, but I was almost fall back on the stick. Smash the nose down, which wasn't good. I just want to see what the elevator looked like in the flare. Hold on. It's quite hard to see, unfortunately. Yeah, hopefully I'll illuminate a little bit with the lights. Yeah, look how far up it... Look, that's full back almost. It's a little bounce. I mean, look, when I was trying to get the nose wheel down, look at the elevator, look. It's like, I fall down, like, almost full up, and then that brake, look, I was trying to land the nose, but it slammed down. Alright. Let's have a look from the tower. Oh, that's really killing my FPS. Jesus. 12 FPS. This is explained like when you zoom in to default scenery and clouds. And... Yeah, it was firm. No tail strike though. Maybe it's because I've got 80 tons of cargo, I don't know. It's all CG's in limits. Ah, at least we made the exit. That's good. Check flap 70. Yeah, flap 50. That was flap 50. Right then, anyway, I'll pop you in the view of a stowaway so you can see his view from the Approach and landing. Speed break. Yeah, that's just the replay. It was definitely retracted on the taxi, otherwise it would have moaned at me. But yes, thank you very much for tuning in. Joined by the Rotate MD11 again. Very busy in Germany today. Thanks to all the controllers for getting us in safely. There we are. Speed break. Stoned slightly. Cool. And we'll fly this aircraft again very soon. If you enjoyed it, don't forget to like. Subscribe if you're watching out of curiosity to stay up to date with latest content, and I'll be live again very soon, no doubt, in another fun, entertaining aircraft for your amusement. But I do really enjoy doing this still, and I hope you guys do too. Thanks to all the members for your continued support and everyone that donated as well for your generosity. Right, enjoy your evening, guys. See you soon. Bye bye.
Approaching minimums.